Hi, this is Rabbi Ariann Weitzman serving Bnai Keshet Reconstructionist Synagogue in Montclair. This week we're talking about Pinchas. Pinchas is an especially unusual character in that his very brief story spans two parshiot. Last week in Parshat Balak, we read about Pinchas' zealotry in killing two people, Cosby and Zimri, who he believed to be part of a mass Israelite descent into Moabite idolatry and away from God. In response to his act, God abruptly ends a plague which had been terrorizing the Israelite encampment, purportedly as a punishment for this idolatry. Thus ends last week's Parsha. While perhaps we're used to overzealous or even violent acts coming to good ends in Torah, the beginning of this week's Parsha might still surprise us. Pinchas' story picks up this week with an offer by God to Pinchas of a covenant of peace, and a promise that his line will have an eternal covenant of priesthood as a reward for his act. On its face, the story is quite simple. The Israelites are engaged in wholesale rejection of their own covenantal relationship with God. The Moabites and their allies, the Midianites, are somehow tricking them into this rejection by means of seduction. Moses and the leaders of Israel don't seem to be able to do anything to stop it. Only an impassioned act on behalf of God's honor can shock the community back to its senses. On the other hand, this story is more complex than it seems. When Cosby, an Israelite notable, brought Zimri, a Midianite from an important ancestral house, into his chambers, were they engaged in idolatry? Or were they simply getting married? We read in Numbers 25:6 that Cosby brought a Midianite woman over to his brothers, his kin, in the sight of Moses, before bringing her into his chambers. Was this act an act of flagrant disregard for Moses? Or was it a public act of celebration, of making sure that all was above board? The echoes between this possible marriage and Moses' own marriage to Zipporah, daughter of a Midianite priest, are obvious. Although Zipporah was maligned by Miriam and Aaron, she had an important role to play in preserving the spiritual identity of her family with Moses. And her father, Yitro, had an essential role to play in supporting Moses' continued leadership of the Israelites. This story represents a growing level of anxiety by the Israelites about the threats of neighboring peoples, some real, some imagined. Will these people threaten us militarily? Will they destroy our families and our lineage through intermarriage? And worst of all, will they then destroy us spiritually? This anxiety and the violent rhetoric and behavior it breeds continues to plague the stories of our ancestors throughout the rest of Tanakh. But God's covenant with Pinchas, separated in this parsha from his violent act, perhaps serves as a corrective instruction. Leadership, embodied in the priesthood, should serve to ensure continued peace in the community and not sanction the destruction of life as a solution to spiritual fears. God's decision to end the plague may not have been an acceptance of Pinchas' actions, but an act of regret and a statement of hope that both God and humanity may find a new way forward together. May we all walk in the spirit of this covenant of peace. Shabbat Shalom.